Hey, what's up, guys? This is Jay Pablo. We're here in Prospect Heights in front of Prospect Heights High School, alma mater to Buckshot of Black Moon. Personally, I went to Norman Thomas High School. Tigers represent. And we're just gonna talk to Buck about like some of the things that have changed, some of the things that made him who he is. He's from right around the corner on Franklin Avenue, so he's like a lifelong resident of this neighborhood. He says he left school kind of early, so it'd be interesting to see, you know, what outside of school helped shape the man that he is today. So let's go catch up with Buck and see what's up. When I was in school, I was the Mac. Buck was strapped with a hill, lyrical contact, knapsack. Filled with the gear that I cheated in a nickel bagger. Yes, indeed. A mad little brother running up on the mall. Fly as hell, hit the ball, play the wall. And all the older people saying, shorty's a badass. But you's a smart little brother, so you're gonna last. They knew the time, they knew the rhyme where to hit you in the least four. I have two daughters, and they love to dance. And
you think they get that from you? The artist aspect?
I think so, yeah. Because I get mine from my pops and my uncle. You know, my father taught my uncle, which was his younger brother, and I got mine from my uncle. Mm. You know, my uncle was a big inspiration for me. Still is, because he does art now.
Oh, okay.
And he often says I'm still breakdancing, but I'm just doing it through my art.
Oh, that's beautiful. You know?
And he was in the M2 May video. He choreographed M2 May, the Juicy video.
The Juicy video?
Yeah, he's actually in it dancing.
I'm gonna go check that one out.
He's the only, man, every time I even talk about that, I get emotional because that was the biggest thing in the world for me.
What was, like, your uncle, he taught you, like, how to dance, too, or, like...
He taught me how to dance that
just
way.
Just like that?
Yeah.
So he would one, do two, routines three. With you
yeah.
and all that?
Yeah, one, two, wow. three, yeah. I never forget it, because he would say, step out, and then go in, come back. He taught us with these two, that was the basic move, like, there, to step out, like that. Like, he's going one, two, three, it was one, two, three, and one, you know, one, two, three. So, after you do that, you would know how to, you know... You
from there,
from there, I learned. I went into breakdancing and popping, and I started doing that for a while. So.
When did you make the transition to rapping from dancing?
'90.
'90.
Yeah.
What made that? You just saw people rapping on.
My friend had the guy who I was dancing for. Mm-hmm. He got locked up.
Oh, okay.
His name was Reese Smooth. So I had no choice but to start rhyming. Because my MC got locked up.
Uh-huh.
So I was like, what am I gonna do now?
Right.
And me and Five was his dancer, like Scoop and Scrap and King.
Right, right, right.
Me and Five FT was his dancers.
Uh-huh.
So Five FT introduced me to Evil D. And after that, we became a group, Black Moon.
Let me ask you this, because you said about the versatility of the school. Is that how, you know, you were like riding skateboards? Because you got that rhyme about like hop on my skateboard and do it.
Well, yeah, like I said, and this is, look, like if you look down that end, the teacher was telling you don't go down that end. Whoever the principal
was. Oh, yeah, she was like Franklin.
Don't go there, you know what I'm saying? And that's my building, that big building right there.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So the teacher was like, the principal, I'd rather, don't go there, because that's where it's cracking at. Go this side, go to Grand Army or go to Eastern Parkway. That's the place where you need to go. And I could imagine for a lot of kids, no way are they going to walk three blocks down just to go there when right there is the train station. But what that shows you is that you got versatility. You got Chinese, you know, white kids, Prospect Heights kids basically is on this side, and all the Puerto Rican and black kids and hood motherfuckers is really on this side.
Mm.
So me personally, I was blessed with the opportunity to be involved in both worlds.
Wow.
You know, I was right in the middle. So it was never a thing where I had to just be on one side.
Right, right.
So back in the days, we was into backpacks, skateboards, and all that stuff early, you know, because it was a part of our culture. And it was because it was an everyday thing, and plus we was kids.
You mentioned the backpacks too, like you pretty much kicked in the door for the whole like quote unquote back rapper shit. But you were just telling me about how like that was how, like a
yeah, that was a culture
thing. That was a,
that was a Franklin Avenue culture. Like other kids would have book bags and have stolen gear or have this and third, and then I would have incense, oils, jewelry, did this, that, because I was the guy that would open my backpack and sell you anything. Whatever's jumping at the time, I'm trying to sell that to you. Because so think of like the oils and those type of things, Egyptian musk and da-da-da, a lot of, and you know, it's surprisingly so, a lot more, like, you know, black kids didn't really wear that. As much as, like, all my customers would come from the Prospect Heights side. And my books used to sell more on the black side.
Oh, okay.
So my books used to sell on the black side, and my jewelry and incense and oil used to sell on the Prospect Heights side. For real. And I used to make, that's how I was surviving every day. That's how I was making a little bit of money every day.
Gotcha. You were saying, you also said filled with the gear that I'd eat and nickel bag of weed.
Yeah.
Franklin was known for weed spots.
Franklin was known for weed and gin. I mean,
yeah, exactly.
You know, look, I G'd the clothes for who got the props, but I don't want to tell, you know.
You don't want to talk about
that. I don't want to promote Gene, right, but right, I did.
What was that, the rain suit, right? You had the Columbia rain
suit? We had the Columbia rain suits, but we actually, I believe we bought those, but we had the Nike buckets, the white bucket I had on.
I remember.
And
that.
We had the Nike suits. I had the blue, white Nike suit. Five had the red and white. You know what I'm saying? And that was boosted. Yeah, you know me. Booming like the speaker with my $100
sneakers. Baggy black jeans, knapsack, and my people. Tell us about that choice, because some people don't recall.
Because there was some graffiti on the door right here. I'll never forget it because it was the third door. And the guy asked me, the security guards, like how you see them now. He was like, look, you know, I'm closing these doors in 2 seconds. Whoever's not inside, you get left out. You know, that's it. So I'm like, I'm sitting right here trying to decide what I'm going to do. I'm standing right here, And I'm like, what am I going to do? If I don't go into school, I'm in trouble.
Right.
But if I don't go to the MCA, I'm going to lose that opportunity. You know, what do I do? Do I go straight to the office or do I go in school? And every kid is starting to walk in. They're starting to walk in. And I'm the last guy out here. So now the security guard is looking at me. He's like, what are you going to do? Because I'm closing the door. And I'm sitting here like this. I'm like, he's like, look, you know what? He's like, look, I'm closing the door. And what are you going to do? And he said, all right, you're staying out, obviously. Boom. And he closed the door, and I just walked to the door, and I was like, yo, now I have no choice not to fail. You know, because this door got closed on me, and that's it. Once this door got closed on me, I knew that because I had made the decision to go to work, I had no choice but to fail. Like, I couldn't fail. I had to make it. I had to make it. Because my decision to go there was really my biggest moment in life as far as what decision I was going to make. And look, they got arts, they got music, they got all these things now. So if they had them back then, maybe I wouldn't have made that decision.